they hold. Child weakness to be a bad man, child. We're here outside Jungle Mania, yeah. And I'm here with Flinty Badman of one half of the Ragga Twins. Hi, Flinty.
Yes, respect.
Right. So first off, let's say you and your brother, you both come from a reggae background. Uh-huh. Can you tell you how you started in reggae music?
Well, basically, you know, reggae music obviously played in my house from when growing up. But the really big breaks that we got in reggae music was when we started off with our own little sound system. But when we joined the big sounds, the first big sound we joined was a sound called Jamarcus from Tottenham. Then from that sound, D-Man went on to a sound called Unity, which was one of the biggest sounds in London, in the UK, I should say. And I was on a sound called Gem Magic. Then I left Gem Magic and went on Unity with D-Man. And, you know, that's how it was for us. That's how we come up in the. It's short, but there's more to it than that. But you know, short and sweet. You know what I mean?
So I know you got into hardcore with the Shut Up and Dance label. How did that come about?
What happened when we left the Unity? When we left the sound system thing, we wanted to get into something different. And the opportunity came along when Shut Up and Dance sampled Demon Rocker off one of the Unity cassettes. Yeah, of one of the cassettes that we used to record from the dances. And they was putting out a tune called Lamborghini. So they went to see D-Man. That time D-Man was working in a pawn shop. And they came there to see him and said, "Why, we wanna put out this tune." So D-Man said, "Yeah, cool, you know what I mean?" And D-Man said to them, "But we wanna do something different. We've been doing the reggae and we wanna get into some, you know what you're doing?" And he said, "Come up and see them." We come up and see them, and by chance, one of the guys we went to school, primary school with, we knew the family and everything. And the other guy was a guy we know, the same Smiley was a guy we know from Hackney, you know what I mean?
Wicked. Now, I remember them times, man. I remember when I saw you and your brother perform on the stage at Living Dance. That was like my early Living Dream. Yeah. I mean, we don't even see raves that big again these days. Mm. So at the time, your debut album with Shut Up and Dance were called Reggae Owes Me Money. And I know that was quite a controversial title at the time. Why was that?
The reason being, because obviously we just come out of reggae music. But, you know, the reason why we said reggae owes us money, because, you know, we've done a lot of things for reggae music and we wasn't getting paid. You get me? So it was just simple as that. It was just across the board. In the reggae industry, we wasn't getting paid. And straight.
So some people say that you're the pioneers of jungle music. Why would they say that?
Well, when we left from reggae, we was like the first reggae artist to come over to the Acid House. We came over in 1990. The Acid House was playing. And we brought the reggae influence into the acid music. So when we done that, people started to hear it, and everybody started picking up on this, you know, bringing reggae into the music, and then it just evolved into jungle. So, you know, basically, there was reggae people in the acid house, going to the raves and that, but they weren't doing the music. But when we came into it, because of our background in reggae music, people from that scene came over as well, which kind of made the scene, because, you know, with the music that was making, with the reggae samples and all that, a lot of the people that was in the scene couldn't understand it. But when the influx of people from the reggae industry came over and started raving to the music, that's when, you know, they started to get a good understanding of the music. And a lot of them now are going back and listening to the reggae and finding out where that reggae music come from, you know what I mean? So it's good.
What do you feel makes jungle music so great?
It's the soul that's in the music, isn't it? The reggae that's in the music, the R&B that's in the music. That's why jungle music is so good.
And would you say that's why there's still a demand for events like Jungle Mania and this?
It's coming back around. It's big in 2013. The jungle music, people are remaking this. There's a new school jungle now that is being made. And it's, you know, it's a bit faster, but it's fitting in. So it's a new wave of jungle coming through. So that's why events like this would happen. And you can see it's not only older people in the place. Young people that didn't even go to jungle raves before. They don't even know about certain jungle raves that was going back on. But they're in here now listening to jungle and they love it. So yeah, big. Jungle's gonna be big, 2013, trust me.
So, I mean, obviously you and your brother have been going from the very, very, very beginning, and like you're still up here doing it yourself. I mean, I just saw your PA that you done, like, you know, that was bringing back some serious memories for me. And, you know, the two of you still hold your own, you know. What would you say the recipe to your success is?
The recipe to our success is, you know, conscious, intelligent lyrics, no A-class drugs, yeah? And just, you know, just have respect, and you have to respect the crowd, and then they will respect you. You have to respect your fans, and they will respect you. You know what I mean? And you know, just keep yourself on course, and then be humble.
Wicked. What would you say are your top five favorite jungle tracks? I know this is a hard question. Everyone's been struggling with this one, but I want to see what you come with.
The thing is, I'm not really good on names of jungle tracks. That is it. I'm not good on names yet. But I'm gonna try a thing. So I'm gonna say, yeah, Leviticus, incredible. Drum pan sound. We don't know what that one called, but the sample said drum pan sound. Of us, pack up to dig it. That one there. I'm struggling.
That's cool. You gave us a couple.
Yeah.
Right. This is going to be an easy one because you got plenty to draw for this one. Can you give us one of your favorite jungle memories?
One of my favorite jungle memories. I got loads. I don't even know if I got a favorite. But one of my best ever jungle memories. Jungle. Was Cool London's third birthday bash in Astoria. Yeah? Locked down the whole of West End. Seen straight. Astoria didn't see nothing like that before. Wicked. That is one of my wickedest jungle memories.
It's been a while. Yes, we are the girls. We holding down the beats and blow. We come to mash up the show. Rolling with the beats and the old school blow. Oh, we're moving on the flow. Bad boy MC's mashing up the show now. We mashing it out. Mr. GQ moves with the lyrical sound. We got flavor. We got the raver. Come with the rhythm and we ball out for murder. Murder style. Murder style, we're wicked and wild. We're moving on the rhythm on the cool profile. Yeah, moving as we mash it. Bass got it lashing.
Well, I'm gonna look up right on the scheme.
You're coming to kick.
Y'all picking it. And some other things.
You know, the world's in trouble. The world is in trouble. Oh. All of the ravers, all of the crew, them all again. Ready for this one, explosion! Count it down! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1! 5, 4, 3, 2! Count it down! Hold it as we move the sound! Mickey pussy clumping! Guarantee keep the rhythm now bubbling! We come to mash it right now. Jungle Mania with the old school shout. Shout!
Yes.
Yo, Jungle Mania. I need everybody in the building to make some noise. Push up your hand and scream loud for Mickey Finn and Darren J.
Say.
Yeah.
Right, so we're out here in Jungle Mania, and I'm here with Kenny Ken. Kenny, you are the original Jungle Sound Clash champion.
Oh yeah.
I've got one question to ask you.
What's that?
Have you still got the belt?
Oh, of course I've got the belt. Come on now, T-Bone man. Of course I've got the belt. No one ain't getting that belt from me.
What was the secret to winning?
The secret to winning was selection. That was the secret. Instead of mixing, trying to mix the tunes and trying to do fancy mixes, I didn't mix. If you listen to it, you'll see that I didn't mix. All I've done was pure, just draw tune after tune, like a sound clash.
Are you going to draw any of them dubs tonight?
I played already, but I did draw one.
What one was that?
The last tune I played.
Okay, right. You've got a label. I know you had Mix and Blend. Do you have another one? You have still a Mix and Blend. Have you got anything new coming in the pipeline?
Yeah, we just mastered Lala Bella VIP featuring the Ragga Twins and a drumstep version. Oh, thank you, baby. A drumstep version of Murder You.
Right. Obviously, we're here and there's plenty of vibes out there. What do you think makes jungle music so great and it differs to other music?
See, a lot of people get confused with jungle, you know what I mean? Some people think that jungle is just drum and bass with ragga samples in it. But it's not about that. Jungle is a vibe, you know what I mean? And like, you know, there's drum and bass, you can separate the two if you want to, you know what I mean? And like, but jungle, you know when a man's playing jungle and you know when a man's playing drum and bass. If you're into this thing like I'm into it, then you can tell the difference. But to some people it's all the same, but to me it ain't. Jungle has got a completely different vibe. Because there's more vocals, there's more soul, there's more, you know, there's more of, how can I say it, man? A lot of the drum and bass, what the kids are listening to, no disrespect, but it's a lot of it is just noise to me. You know what I mean? Some of it's good, but I can't play that. I have to play stuff that's got soul and has got feeling, and I like to see the girls whining their batty, and you know what I mean? Things like that, you know?
Now, obviously, you're one of the pioneers, and you've been here from the beginning. Can you give me a couple of your favourite jungle memories?
Favourite, sorry?
Jungle memories. Memories from jungle, from the jungle
venues. The number one is Paradise Club.
Okay, not venues. That's good, venues. Memories.
Oh, memories.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Remember when we went to Switzerland? Remember this Kevin Street was going to beat us up?
Yeah, we went to Switzerland one day. Me, Det and Frost.
Jumping Jack Frost.
Me, Det and Frost went to Switzerland and the security thought they could have us over. But we nearly had them over, didn't we, D? Right? We showed them that we weren't no punks, you know what I mean? So, but like, you know, I'm not a violent person, don't get me wrong, I'm not violent at all, but, you know, the promoter tried to run away with our money and thing, and I got a bit upset, and security tried to put their hand on me, and I had to show them that can't run, you know what I mean? That's one of my memories with me, Det and Frost, and Det and Frost had my back as well, so that was good. The best one, obviously, is winning the Sound Clash.
Of course.
ring the bell. Can you give me five of your top jungle tracks?
Right, the first one has got to be D Living Y. The second one, from back in the day I'm talking about, not up front, back in the day, has got to be Intelligent Woman by DJ Rap. The third one I would say is what I really liked as well was Let's Go. I forget the proper title of it. Potential Bad Boy. Right? And obviously Jungleistic Man by Conga Natty, Rebel MC. Here Comes the Drums by Doc Scott. There's loads, man. I could stand here all day. You know, there's loads, you know what I mean?
And finally, this is for me personally. Obviously, you know, I've done garage and stuff like that, and I came back on the scene. And this little kid, well, I said young man, hit me up online telling me he's little Chrissy. how do you feel to, you know, to be a father and a father figure to one of the new, well, I'd say new emerging, one of the top DJs out there?
A lot of people say, I'm glad you got me on camera now, right? Because a lot of people say that it's down to me why he's where he is, right? Trust me. All I've done was planted a seed. That's all I've done. All the rest is all down to him, right? I've not got involved in anything he's doing. He's done it all off his own back. Obviously, you know, like getting work, I've helped him out a bit that way, back in the day, early. But like, you know, apart from that, everything he's doing now is down to him. You know, he's a deck destroyer, basically. You know what I mean? Simple.
Oi! Oi, Jungle Mania! Jungle Mania! Jungle Mania before me and Moose head out. Listen, tonight happens to be a special night, yeah? Tonight happens to be a special night. And I need to let you know, it would be nice if we had much more jungle parties. Don't you say? Don't you say? You know what I mean? It's nice to see everybody come up for some original jungle music. So big up yourself, yeah? Maxima.
Yeah, that's how we like to represent.
AWOL. It's all about AWOL.
Right. Are you ready for one of the original artists in the scene, you know? You ready? What? Are you ready for the sound like MB inside right now? Come on, man. Yeah. You know the history. Ready for the MB right now? Make some noise, please. Show them the original.
Turn me up, turn me up, turn me up.
Alongside
General Levy. Yeah, let's do this. Yes, Moosey. Turn me up.
DJ and producer. Right, so we're at Jungle Mania.
Yeah, man.
What to you both makes Jungle Mania so special? Jungle Mania is very special, Mr. T-Bone, because it's not just only something that's bringing a forward movement for the jungle music, but also is a very strong education of old school jungle music for the young ones that are coming through that don't really know the history of it, and for the new ones that are quite mature and only got into it through the old new stuff. So it's a good foundation for the music. You know, it started in a small club and now it's in a big club. So obviously the movement is working. Do you know what I mean? And it's bringing back and bringing out a lot of DJs that thought that they weren't really, didn't have much to offer anymore. But, you know, they've got a lot of selection and we need that history within the scene. You know what I'm saying? So
I'll tell you what I like. This is like one of the first dances I've been to where man's paying 100% what I would call jungle. The amount of jungle dances that are promoted as jungle, and I hear drum and bass. And that's a big political thing. Drum and bass, jungle, this, that, this and that. But that is jungle, what's playing in there right now. That's Jungle Mania to me.
So why do you think that jungle has lasted so long and there's still such a big demand for it?
Because it's got soul, it's got energy, it's got a vibe in the music that, you know, I'm not disrespecting drum and bass, but it's got a certain in it that drum and bass doesn't have in it. It's got different musical backgrounds. You got hip hop in it, you got ragga in it, you got soul in it, you got rare groove in it. It ain't steady one, you know, one kind of thing that everybody's on and same kind of routing. Everyone does their own thing in it. It's open. So it's open to more people, different people from different backgrounds and rah rah rah.
Ooh. Okay. Yeah. Like, you're one half of, you know, one of the most famous jungle DJ and MC combinations.
Yeah.
What would you say is the secret to your and Brocky's success?
Not too far off what Remark just said now, really, about the different sounds within the music. We've always played jungle. New jungle, you know, we've gone through the stages, you know, the stuff that people consider old school jungle. And the music jungle has always progressed, you know. Some people took hold of that sound, just the drum and bass sound, although the jungle sound's always been there. So we've always been stuck on the jungle thing. And, you know, because we've worked with each other on the radio regularly, coming to the events and working live for a crowd, you know, over the years, you know, it's easy to build up the rapport between each other. So I think it's the rapport between us, and I think people like that when they can see something. People have stayed together for so long, you know what I'm saying? I think it's more them than us knowing the reason. The ravers have more the reason than I do. I think maybe, you know, people like a team, you know what I'm saying?
Remark, you being a producer yourself, obviously we've seen MBeat perform tonight, which was, you know, for a long time. We know that Levy's been performing the tune, but he's coming back on the road. What did you think watching him do his PA and using Ableton Live and stuff like that? Did it inspire you at all?
Ableton and all that, I'm not really in it still, but he's doing his thing, you know what I mean? I think, well, I know no one really plays vinyl no more and all that, but I'm more of, you know, I'm playing CDs and stuff nowadays. I'm not really, all this Ableton stuff and set up mixed business and all that, I'm not in it, man. It's taking everything away from DJ skills and all that, so everybody's a fucking everyone's a top DJ now, rah rah, because they can mix with all these timed up things and all that. But yeah, boy, respect to MBeat still, you know what I mean? He's done his thing, done his PA. Bad.
I think maybe it's been a bit misconstrued, because I know in the prep, for him prepping it, he was more trying to do a live performance than a DJ set. So he was more trying to like take the tunes in it and chop them up and stuff like that, more than somebody like using Ableton to like mix. I think he was more just playing this stuff and was, you know, because it's harder, because he's only got maybe two tracks with artists to perform, he was trying to, you know, perform some of his tracks and stuff like that, you know?
Yeah.
Right, are you still producing or just exclusively DJing now?
Exclusively DJing, exclusively producing just for myself, 100% dubs. I don't put no tunes out, everything. That's what keeps my DJ sets different from everybody else. I still play old school jungle sets, but like, to be completely honest, I don't know how much times people can play the same old style tunes. Seriously, because I listen radio day in, day out, every single set for the whole day, everyone's playing the same jungle tunes. Like, all right,
jungle's raising again right now. But it's going to disappear quick unless people start making some new tunes. And everybody keeps saying to me, can I remix your tune? Make a fucking new jungle tune. How do you expect jungle to move forward if all everyone's hearing is the same tunes remixed 1,000 times? Even the 140. You know, it's just a madness. They need to start. If everyone wants jungle to raise, you know, as it's on the steps again now, it's coming up again now, then make some tunes, man. Stop begging man to remix their old tunes and all that. Use your own fucking head, use your own heart and make what you want to make. Stop running off other man's ideas and even trying to make a paper off man's other ideas, you know what I mean? That's what I think.
Depp, like, you've been around, obviously, from very much from the beginning of the jungle. Give us one of your favourite jungle memories.
Favourite jungle memories? That's strange. You start off asking me, I've been around for years, you know how many memories I have? Man, I've got so many memories. Good memories or bad memories? What kind of memories do you want?
Good.
You want good memories?
Positivity around here.
Okay. A good jungle memory. All right, my very first event, I suppose, because it was their first event. It was Jungle Fever in the East End, like Shoreditch and Curtain Road. There was like a warehouse on Curtain Road. And what made it special was that back in the day, people used to spend more on production because it was coming off the back of like acid out and hardcore. And their thing was always very, you know, good, big production. So it was coming off the back of that. So the production was just like, it was, I think it was a Halloween. And the production was crazy. They had all coffins there and, you know, big iron gates and.
I turn street lights down to darkness. I don't want to be the one for start this. Anywhere can't touch this,
respect,
past this.
Respect, anyway.
Where do you get lost, man? This is my fucking. This is my.
Hold tight, Depp. We're linking, man.
Get out of there, man. Get out, man.
Bro.
Reggie, man, the Reds, man. This is my. Come on, man. This is Hollywood here. This is Hollywood right here. Do you mind? This ain't the BBC. All right, where was I? Oh yeah, so it was just Jungle Fever at Curtain Road, really, and the production was really cool. And it was the first time that, like, I'd been able to perform on a stage that had such good production. It was like the stage was done up like a graveyard. And I'll never forget that. That was really good. And Tim Westwood was in, I think he was in Room 2. Yeah.
Wicked. Remark.
And you, give us a jungle memory, man.
You know, yes, it's for real. You know what it is? There's so many. You know, I'll tell you, one of my big ones was doing a PA at Laserdrome, and you actually saved me at last minute, remember?
Oh,
you come
an
MC for it.
I remember that, yeah.
Because you know what? After I come off a weekend rush and I started producing, I just disappeared from DJing and all that. I was just producing. But I was putting out tunes. But then when I done the PA, it's like a whole load of people realised, right, you made that tune. Mm. But I remember that, Laserdrome when I done a PA. That was one of my.
Okay, I mean, it's a very, very hard question to ask, but give me some of your favourite jungle tracks.
Leviticus. Represent.
You know, I couldn't say a favourite, man. There's too many to me.
Not a favourite, but just, you know, throw a couple out there.
General Levy's incredible.
Okay. One that you will always bar for the rewind.
Babylon.
Wicked.
Oh, Babylon. Yeah, Babylon.
Yeah. Babylon.
Cool.
Swing, eat it, let's go, come in the beer, go, rent them. members.
Jumpy Jack Frost outside Jungle Mania.
Yo, what's up?
What's good? What's good? What's good?
Now, you know me, bro. Sorry, excuse me. Yeah.
I don't think there could be an old school jungle rave without you or Brian being there, to be honest with you, because you both run obviously V Recordings, which undoubtedly had some of the most biggest jungle tunes, you know, in the history of it.
I love
it. What would you say is the secret to your success?
Hard work, dedication, waking up early in the morning, living good, living clean. Dealing with my artists, as much as a disrespect. Now, dealing with my artists with respect. You know what I mean? And it's hard work, you know what I mean? It's dedication to the game.
So, obviously, tonight is an old school jungle rave.
Yeah.
How do you think the vibes have differed to how it was back in the early 90s?
Well, I think people are really, you know what I mean? People are really appreciating it. And as you can see, there's probably a whole new generation of people out there. That's, you know I mean, that's maybe some of them missed out in the first time around. People coming out here to appreciate it tonight and just getting down and enjoying themselves, as you can see, the wicked atmosphere around there tonight, you know what I mean?
How do you find playing at Jungle Mania is different to playing at other drum and bass raves?
Well, obviously it's a jungle team and you get to experiment, because like, me myself, I'm playing that new jungle, old jungle, I'm just mixing it all up. You can kind of do that now, because I think they're making a lot of new jungle in the format of the old style, you know what I mean? And when you come somewhere like this, you can kind of full range of the music. You know what I mean? Some of the drum and bass raves are a bit, you know, a bit tatty. So let's put it that way, you know what I mean? But it's all gravy, bro.
Okay, so I know that you've got a few labels now. You've got V, you've got Liquid V.
Yeah.
Do you still do Philly Blunt?
Yeah, still do Philly Blunt. We've got Gangsta Remix coming out soon. Motherfucker Remix. And you know what I mean? Like, you know, obviously we've got an album project, you know, like, coming up soon. And there's a lot of shit going on, yeah.
Okay, is the album got a title yet?
No.
And where can we expect to see that?
Probably before the end of the year, definitely.
Okay, so I know that you've got a new clothing line coming out. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Team Frost, baby! No, yeah. Yeah, I got a new clothing line, right? www.team-frost.com. You know what I mean? It's like, just like Team Frost stuff. People that want to come and rep with me and just be part of the team. You know what I mean? And, you know, I've always been into clothes and that, so I just thought I'm going to start designing a couple of little bits and bobs here. And you know I mean? You're going to see it develop more over the years. Done quite a lot of borders already in the first. I started it in January, and like, I mean, nearly 5 months in, we're looking good. Yeah.
Nice. Okay, so you're going back to back tonight with Brian.
Yeah, my business partner, my homie. I'm gonna go back to back and get him a special tonight, man. Definitely.
Okay, we're gonna hear any exclusive dubs.
Course.
Okay, and another thing. what does it mean to you to like play at Jungle Mania?
It means a lot, man, because you know it's like this is the biggest jungle thing of the year so far, right? And it's a big look, Bridge and Elliot, obviously my boys, and I rep hard for them all the time, and I mean it's good to be here, man. Good to see you, I ain't seen you for a long time.
I know, I think the last thing I saw you was back to 95 on my birthday, man.
Oh, man.
Right, what I'm going to say to you, GQ wouldn't answer this question, but yeah. Can you give me five jungle tunes? I'm not going to say your best, because there's too many, yeah. But give me five jungle tunes to you, stand out.
Big Band, Heavy, The Burial, obviously my tune, what I've done. Bonanza Kid, Philly Blunt Records, obviously my label. Gangsta, obviously on my label. And another one. Sets me, obviously, on my label.
Right, we're going again. Give me five tunes on your label.
I don't think I could do that.
Okay, here comes the bass again, let's go.
Jungle Mania, and I've got DJ Dextrous, the King of the Jungle, and Cool FM's Brocky. Guys, I think it's amazing both together at Jungle Mania, because
you know, two of you are definitely your pioneers for the sound. How do you both feel being in something like Jungle Mania? And how does it feel based on like the jungle raves of the mid-90s?
Well, for me, it's a beautiful thing. You know, 20 years down the line, they're still getting 3,000-4,000 people coming out to the music. It's got, you know, it's a new thing called New School Jungle now, which is evolving it. So it's a great thing. It's a beautiful thing, man.
Very hard to answer that one. It's the first time for a long time that I've been out to a jungle rave, and it's really nice. Really good to see a great turnout. Good to see some old faces, and I'm going to emphasise the old because we're getting old. But it's really nice. Really nice to see some old faces, and it's good to hear the music still thriving, and it's good to know that, you know, you've been part of the whole framework of the thing, and it's still growing. So it's nice, great, really good, really good.
Brocky, you're half of one of the most famous jungle and DJ and MC combinations. What do you think the secret is to your success, and why do you think that Brocky and Det are so popular?
Success, the love of the music, that's the main thing. Cool FM is a major part. People like Dexterous helped me at my early days with dub plates that, you know, I was smashing people with. King of the Jungle. So sit down in his yard.
I'll give you that fiver later.
But it's just the love of the music, and I just love the music. So me and Det love what we do. I appreciate it. It's the best job in the world. It's the best scene in the world, and the best ravers, and the best cameraman. Pay me later for that.
Yeah, all right, Dex. Incrementally. Why do you think there's still demand for things like this, like Jungle Mania and these kind of jungle events?
I think it's important for the young people to see where it all started and sort of bring it back home. Let me go back to the why it's important. Yeah, it's good for people to know what the foundation is about, you know? And I'm not 100% sure what's happening in the scene as it is on a sort of general basis, but coming back to something like it is like sort of walking into a sort of time warp, you know? And it's just really good to see. I think it's really good for the youngsters to kind of find out what the whole thing was about, what started the whole thing, and it's really great. I've seen MB, just seeing Remark over there, and Foundation, man, you know? It's really good, really
Foundation.
Good. And one behind the camera as well, Mr. T-Bone, you know?
That's right, Foundation.
We'll interview you in a minute.
And the kids just need to know, most of the up-and-coming DJs, you know, they missed out on the jungle scene, so they want to get their history. So I think it's a great thing that they want to come out to these sort of parties, the DJs and ravers, and get some history in them. And you know, and appreciate the people like Dexterous, yourself, me, all the artists here that have been in the game for 20 years, pushing the love and doing what we're doing. So I love it, you know. When I see a 16-year-old jumping out to jungle, to me it's a beautiful thing. That's going to pay bills and keep the music game for everybody else for years to come. So I can't knock that. I've got to love it.
So Brocky, you got a label, Undiluted, is that correct?
That's right.
Have you got any new stuff coming out that we should look out for?
The last stuff I had was a tune called Dog Hearted, and I had a thing called Dangerous. Done very well.
Listen, don't worry what anyone says. Brocky is the best DJ.
I have respect.
Brocky!
Don't keep messing up my enemies, I beg. Right, let's start again.
That's just the man name, innit?
I can't control them.
The label Undiluted, I've got some new stuff coming out soon. We're going to take it a bit more on, the next step is to take it more commercial, as in the word, not commercial, but more mainstream, because we've got to spread the wings. I think the mainstream side of things ain't representing what's really happening in the rave scene at all. It's all dubstep, and there's nothing wrong with dubstep, but it's just not happening what's happening on the roots. So we was there first, man. So I just want to take my label a bit more commercial wise and spread the wings, you know?
Okay, Dex, what about you? Are you back in the studio? Is anything new coming from you?
You should know about that. We were doing a bit of a sneaky just the other day. No, we're definitely going to get back on it. I think it's high time we return to where we kind of cut our teeth as producers, you know? So yes, we will be coming back with a few things. Not just on the sort of drum and bass tip. We're going to spread our wings in other areas as well. And we love music, you know, and that's why. It's all about music.
Not putting a box or genders. About exactly. The love of all music. And we grew up on all music: reggae, soul, rare groove, pop. You know what I mean? So when people say to me, "Oh, Brocky or Dexter, why you make that music?" We're from all music, and I want the youngest ravers and the DMB reps, you know, worldwide. It's, you know, we know you love your thing, but it's about music. This scene would never be where it wasn't. It wasn't for sampling everyone's music.
Yeah, exactly. Well, that's the whole essence of jungle. It's a melting pot of all our past sort of influences, you know? And that's how the whole jungle thing started. You know, it's the same way that hip hop evolved, you know? It's the same thing. That's our UK version of hip hop, so.
Okay, could you both give me some of your favourite jungle memories? Brocky?
Wow.
Oh, don't let me go.
Jungle memories. My first memory I'll give you then would be, I can only really give you one that stands out. Two, really, for me as an artist. When I was playing at Rose, Paul Ibiza's Ibiza Records years ago, with the Rocket. Me and Dex, first time playing out, and there was two girls sitting behind us. And I think it's our first time playing out, I got 80 quid, I was over the moon. But anyway, so these two girls were sitting behind us, and they came up to me and Dex, and said to me and Dex, you two are really good, you're gonna get far. That was 20 years ago, and I'm still here. The next one was Kenny Ken, when I was up and coming again. He said the same thing to me one time, he tapped me my shoulder and said, you're quite good, mate. And I love that.
Dex, same to you.
One night that springs to mind, Coventry, The Edge.
Oh shit.
Oh my god. Something else. I remember I can't remember how many plates I gave you for that. Yeah, I know. One after the next. And I remember I left that night on a high because King of the Jungle had arrived, you know, and I think that night was so sort of significant,
and
you know.
That night was King of the Jungle, and Jungle Fever that arrived in one night. We brought London to Coventry, to the Midlands, and showed them what
epic,
London's about.
Epic night.
A wicked night.
Thank you.
Make some noise for Rena May. Yeah. I thought I'd do something a little slow, a little special for you, a little mix up. Who remembers this? Come on, let's do this, let's go, let's move.
Godfather in his own right.
How you mean?
So, G.
Yeah.
What is it that you like about Jungle Mania?
You know what? There's a few things, but some of them it might be. You know what I mean? Some of it is some politics, right? So I'm gonna keep it. You know what I mean? Like so. But one thing I like about Jungle Mania, it's a nice mixture of people, right? And everybody still vibes in. You know what I mean? People still craving for that. You know what I mean? Style of original jungle music. You know what I mean? I'm still dealing with DMB and all them things there. And, you know, it's good music and everything else. You know what I mean? Some tunes are a bit way out, but it's nice when you have parties like this. You need more parties like this to bring in some of the old heads, you know what I mean, to come and listen to some proper rhythm. You understand what I mean? We could be here all night, I'll tell you. You know what I mean, Steve? I'll tell you why. You know what I mean? You need to have parties like this. But when you go in there, you see the vibe popping off. It's like, come on, man. You know what I mean? Original, old school jungle rhythm, right?
Why do you think that the demand for jungle music has lasted
come
so
on.
Long?
God, sorry, I can't understand.
Why do you think the demand for jungle music has lasted so long?
Because, it's music, innit? It's rhythm. You know what I mean? If you go through the spectrum of time of music, you'll hear, you know what I mean? You'll hear certain types of style of drum and bass and things like that. But people are craving for some old school, just good music. Do you understand what I mean? You gotta remember, you know, that jungle music brought a lot of people together. Do you understand what I mean? No matter what color, what creed or whatever, it brought a lot of people together. And that was important for the scene, you know what I mean? And for the music in general, you know what I mean? And that in itself is a beautiful thing. When you go out on stage and you look amongst the people and you see, you know, black, white, Asian, and you see all colour and creed of people partying, you know what I mean? Yo, you don't even understand the feeling. trust me, do you know what I mean?
What does it mean to you to perform at Jungle Mania?
It's a big deal, you know what I mean? You know, I'm doing a lot of big parties and all them things there, but to get the road call to come back and do this, you know what I mean? There's no way you could turn it down. You understand what I mean? There could be nothing that could make me stop me coming here tonight. You understand what I mean? And the most beautiful thing about it as well is I get to see all the original man, you know what I mean, who I don't see, you know what I mean? I don't get to see, but it's nice to see everybody again, you know what I mean? And everybody's like, you know what I mean? Shit, you don't even, yo, let me mash up the camera, you know? You don't understand, it's just amazing feeling to see everybody again, the old crew, the original family. Jungle music, man, you know what I mean?
All right, name me your top five jungle tunes.
I've got too many, man.
You've got to give me five.
No.
You've got to give me five.
I can't.
You've got to give me five.
No, I can't.
All right, you've got to give me one then.
I can't. I'm not giving you none. Because I don't want anybody to feel bad. You know what I mean? I'm not calling them. Right? So let's skip that.
I'll give you one then. I'll give you one.
See, you was there anyway.
I'll give you one.
I'll give you one.
Roll the beat.
That was all right. It's a good tune. You know what I mean? That's what I'm saying to you. There's so much rhythm. And you was there, so you know.
Just a question. Give me two.
Let's move on.
Give me two.
I'm not giving nothing. Let's move on.
Before I ask you who your favourite DJ is.
You know what I mean? My favourite DJ. You know what, yeah? You know what I mean? That's what I'm saying. I have to call everybody.
I have a jump in one time.
Right. I have to call everybody. Right?
10 time wheel up.
And if you're talking about best DJ,
if
you're talking about best DJ, you could never say to me that to you. That's out of order to say.
Well, exactly. I've done it because you wouldn't give me the five tunes. I know you thought about it, didn't you?
That's out of order. But you know what? I've worked with some of the greatest. You understand what I mean?
Frosty.
I've worked with some of the greatest, and they're still there. You know what I mean? Oh, you're talking to me, you're talking to Frost. What's happening in there?
I said, come here, I'm talking to you. You're not giving me five tunes. Give me one.
You know what I mean?
Give me one.
Reinforce, you know what I mean? No, man, I'm not even
going to do that.
You know what I mean? I'm not going to do that.
Yo! Wicked. Jungle is massive! Wicked. Yo! Big up! Hard original! What we tell him? Well, big up! Hard original, jungle is massive! The original dancehall jungle is there!
Wicked. Yeah. We don't have to play it again, brother. Let's do it.
Mad. Wicked. Original. Well, big up. Hard original jungle is massive. The original dancehall jungle is there. General Levy alongside MB's. The world is in trouble. Hey, tell them.
Yo, my dear, you love them, must bring them like a windmill.
You talk with them, got to know we got to say,
pull up!
We're mad them, MB's. We're mad them. Wicked. Jungle is massive. Wicked. Jungle is massive. Wicked, original, well big up. How the original jungle is massive. The original dancehall jungle is there. Gentlemen, leave you alongside MBs. The world is in trouble.
I want to tell them,
hey, Inca, about general. Sensation, I want to come. Inca, about general. Sensation. Yo, money will on them, I send them like a windmill. You talk for them, go to them, but we got the skill. That's good, that's all it's ready upon the bill. Girl, feel with vice, dreams get fulfilled. Fast time, minimum, cold, chill. I got winners, I got winner, over the hill. Walk out the city, that I must say, that I must say, ill.
Testing that the MB to the
must say, that I must say, ill. Come now! Have mercy. Have mercy. All the girls, have mercy. So what? Booyaka. General up on.
Booyaka.
MB run the dance.
Booyaka.
With a dead bag, no talk.
kill him all. We still live in my name, and I get my man, I get my man. Kill my man, in the master, we get our agenda. Bring him in the man, bring him in the man, bring him in the man. I shot, bring him in the man, bless him. He just told him, feel the rest, tell him money, bring him in the man. MBJ call for murder.
Icky, icky.
General, you call me mad. Murder will and them, I swing them like a windmill. You talk for them, tell them how we got the skill. Dance car nice, that's when they pull the bill. Girls here with vice, she's getting fulfilled.
Most of them, I'm in the middle of the gun, I'm in the middle of the trail. I got me, I'm in the middle of the hill. Back up, they say, down in the most, they say, the most, the ill. They say, to the yummy, to the better, go right your way. Icky, icky. Wicked, wicked, bow, bow, bow. Icky, icky. Wicked, 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 bow, bow, bow. Ain't got a man chain, booyaka, sedentary. Sensational. Ain't got a man chain around. Sedentary.
Sell it.
Stand up at the Jamila,
flipping for cars.
Pierce for your bow with,
what's that steer to tear jars?
Tracy General, he'll get the critical award.
Wicked, wicked. MBJ come for murder.
Cornet Massive. Fire. MBJ, General Levy. Yo. Thank you!
Wicked!
We love you!
Peace! MB General Levy!
Respect! One love! Cha-cha bless! Booyaka, booyaka, when the general up us! Booyaka, booyaka, MB run the dance! Good night! One love! Jah bless! Come in!
So, we're with General Levy, outside Jungle Mania. And Wicked Set, by the way.
Thank you very much.
You always do the business, brother. Right, Levy, you come from a reggae background. Can you tell me how you started out in reggae and music in general?
Well, you know, originally it was on Sound Systems. You know, I started out in a couple of Northwest London. And we was on sounds like Tippertown, Vigilante, local Java Nuclear Power with Joe Nighty and, you know, Cowboy. And, you know, MCs from the corner. So basically from a sound system background, you know, in the early 80s.
So you've just performed the track Incredible that you made with MB.
Yeah.
Can you tell me how that collaboration came about?
Well, that collaboration came about by natural vibrations, you know. Simply as, like, you know, he used to go to school with my first baby mother, and she told me one day that there was a guy at MB, he makes beats and he wants to link up with me. I said, okay, I'll link up with him. is her old school friend. I said, okay. And I linked up with him over East, I was staying over East London these times. And we linked up over East London. I went down to the studio in Hackney and introduced, you know, we linked up from Desso. So basically it was a link, somebody introduced us. You know, I mean, big up Michelle, Mishibu, cause she met the link really and truly. Not people don't even know that. I'm a first baby mother that knew him from school. It's like a school in Marlon. And then she met the link and said, yo, he does beats. He's good now. Link up with him. I said, okay, true, you said that. We will link with him. Because I was a reggae man them time there. Didn't really want to get into this disco music, this jungle thing. But true, she said that. I said, okay, I'll get into this jungle thing. I should love it. East London. Because I'm from Northwest London originally. And that's a reggae kind of corner. So I was over East now, and the jungle thing was really kicking off over that side. And I was resting up over there. So I kind of got in with it. So I was staying over there, chilling out over there. 1993, yeah, because we had our daughter in 1993. So yeah, around them time, 92, 93, that's when we made the link with Marlon. True, a link, a friend of a friend. That's when we made it. Natural vibrations.
Okay, so Incredible was considered one of the biggest jungle tracks in history. Right. Was you both shocked by the level of success, considering that initially was an underground track?
Well, I was, initially I was very shocked because I took it as just like doing I didn't really see it as gonna be a big tune. I took it like as a compliment to like to the scene. I was just gonna like do a tune as a reggae artist passing through, just do a one tune because it was really getting big at that time, the early 90s. So we didn't really think of it as gonna be a big tune. We just saw it as sounded good. Let's go with it, you know, because it wasn't really no real plan. It was just like a vibe. So it was, yeah, just see what happens.
I know you done a track last year with Danny Bird. Do you have any new stuff in the pipeline?
Yeah, I've got a lot of stuff. You can check out General Levy on SoundCloud. Check me out on Twitter. Check General Levy Original on Facebook. I've got a lot of new stuff, a lot of new reggae stuff. I've got a new tune called Roadblock on the Jamafra label. I have a next tune called Adapter on the Waterhouse Rhythm. That's out on all on online. My album Spirit and Fate on iTunes. I've got a lot of stuff. Just check me out, Google me. You will get information about General Levy, you know. If it's any good, you will hear it, you know. But check me out, General Levy One YouTube. I got a lot. SoundCloud. Check me out, General Levy SoundCloud. Boom. Yeah.
Okay, I know that you tour a lot. But can you give me one of your best jungle memories?
One of my best jungle memories is when I went into, as a ragamuffin, I went to Astoria one time and I heard my song, you know, the tune with MB, it played in Astoria and the reaction of the crowd, I don't know what rave it was, but some rave in Astoria, a jungle rave, and they played the tune, and when I saw the reaction of the crowd, I knew that we was onto something big here. There's something seriously going on with this tune. When I saw the amount of people that went crazy for the tune, it's 1994 when it first came out. You know what I mean? Definitely. I was also doing Top of the Pops as well. When it went into the national charts, and we did Top of the Pops. Because as a youth, I always liked Top of the Pops. And I always saw Top of the Pops as if you've gone Top of the Pops, then you've made it. So when we got to Top of the Pops, that was a real figure point for me, a real pinpoint for me to say, yeah, it was something definitely exciting time for me to reach Top of the Pops as a youth.
Okay, brilliant. And finally, can you, obviously other than Incredible, can you give me a couple of your favourite jungle tracks?
I say the Helicopter Rhythm, that's a big tune. And anything with MB do, Style, Rumble, anything with MB do is my favourite jungle tune.
Alright,
listen. Yeah! Well, this is Original Navigator, full up on navigation, don't need no recommendation and don't need no confirmation. Understand me? Original Jungle Gun. Five-star general. I mean, I tell you, it's a jungle music forever. Don't miss it.
Okay, so where will MC Navigate outside Jungle Mania?
Jungle Mania. Give me that question again.
Yeah, there wasn't a question. You took the mic too quick. Right, Navi, so obviously you've been there from the beginning, the same as, you know, Five-O, the same as Moose,
yeah.
Same as a lot of other people.
For real, man.
How would you say Jungle Mania tonight,
yeah,
differs to how jungle raves were back in the mid-90s?
Tell you this straight, yeah? I have never seen a lineup like this yet, ever. First time I saw the lineup, I was like, rotted. Hold on a minute now. General Levy with MB live, Congo Natty,
You ain't even got to go no further than that. I never seen them two on one lineup properly here in the UK yet. You know what I mean? With the same man that was on stage tonight. So to me, it was already a legendary thing. You know what I mean? And I felt honored actually to be involved in it. You know what I'm saying? So big respect to Jungle Mania for that, man. One off.
Why do you think the demand for jungle music has lasted so long?
Because jungle music is a groundbreaking phenomenon. It's a worldwide phenomenon. It's something that was grown out of this city right here. And if you're born and grown in this city right here, so you know, London, you know, it's a serious city, you know. So you know, say from your born here, so you know, you can go anywhere in the world and survive. From your born and growing in London. So you see jungle music, you born in London. So jungle music can go anywhere in the universe and survive. Can't dead, can't done, foundation, groundation. Can't argue with it, man. You know what I'm saying? Pop industry had to, that the industry, the music industry had to heads up, take note and say, yes, jungle music, we're recognizing that as a genre. You understand? I'm proud to have been a part of it, man.
So you've been around for a very long time, obviously from the beginning.
True that.
Can you share with us some of your great jungle memories?
Great jungle memories, too many. But I'll tell you about my greatest jungle memories before I was even emceeing on jungle. And I was in those parties listening to those music. Yeah, you're talking about top five, yeah? All right, let us give you one, 28 Gun Bad Boy, yeah? And We I.E. Yeah, them two tunes. Because you see, when I heard the B-lines, remember, I come from dub because I come from 70s. And when we first start chat sound in 1980, me start chat sound. So them time they appear dub music and reggae dancehall, original reggae dancehall, Dennis Brown, Gregory Isaac, Sugar Minot. Them man there, Barrington Levy, see? So when I hear the B-line come back now, cause when we first started going to dance them, it was just bleepy. But then when them tunes came and the B-line came, I was like, yes, yes, now we know. You understand?
What does it mean to you to perform at Jungle Mania?
Right now, it feels very blessed, and I feel honored, as I said. I know it's bare jungle dons in here tonight. I just saw General Levy just rip the ass out of that in there, trust me. Tore it to shreds, you know? And that's testament to the music. What are you gonna say now? 20 years on, the man just ripped the ass out of that, yeah? Slap way. All right, I don't talk.
All right, last one. Give me five of your most favorite jungle tunes.
Five of my favorite jungle tunes. All right, so well, I've already given you two. 28 Gun Bad Boy, We I.E. Yeah? Let me really, really think about this now. I have to say Original Nutter, right? Because I remember when the tune was made and I was around Shy FX and all them boys there. And we saw the development, so we have to really big up Shy FX and UK Apache for what they done with that track. That was another big one, yeah? But let me think good now. Five really big ones, you know. You see this brother here named LTJ Bookham, yeah? Oh my gosh, he make a tune there. What the tune here? Music. What was the tune that Bookham got? Music. See that tune there, yeah? That just bring tingles down my spine, that tune there. And anywhere you go in the world, because them tunes are known like that all over the world. You understand me? Sure. Big tunes, man. And then I'm gonna say More Fire. And the reason why I'm gonna say More Fire, even though it wasn't back there in the jungle days, right, it kind of brought back that jungle vibe to drum and bass, you know what I'm saying? And Fresh got on it, and Spied Out, Big Up Yourself, you understand? And that was my first hit, and it took me 10 years to get that hit, but I was determined to get a jungle hit, yeah? Carmini and Navigator. And if you have a jungle hit, away you say, man.
Okay, so we're outside Jungle Mania, and I got MC Shabba D here. Shabba, you've been one of the pioneers from way back in the day. What are you thinking of the vibes tonight in Jungle Mania?
To be honest with you, right now I just landed in the place. I'm seeing this ram, this jam, it's going off. I'm on a graveyard shift myself tonight doing the last set, but I'll come check out the vibe. Yeah, it's always good, you know, the jungle reminiscing from back in the days. It looks like it's a roadblock tonight, so yeah, good night. Jungle Mania, big up.
Why do you think jungle's still so strong and there's such a demand for events like this?
Me personally, I mean, I grew up in the era as well. That was my era. I was a young'un, but I was there. I think that people like to reminisce from back in the day as well. A lot of people go out of the new music, the new school music, and they can, you know, relate to the old school music. And, you know, jungle will never die, man. It's proved it strong 21 years, longer than that, you know what I'm saying, running. So, yeah, people like to come out and enjoy themselves and what they was into as well. Do you know what I'm saying? As a youth and whatever, I hear tunes. Yeah, I remember that tune. It's going off though, man. It's coming back round again. You know what I'm saying? You know the wave. The waves. You know, I've been there for a few waves still. Right now, this is like the third, fourth wave for me, and it's big. It's big. It's got DMB as well. That's that side of it, and you got the jungle, the backbone of it. You know what I mean?
What you've been around, obviously, from the very beginning. What would you say is the secret to your success that you can still hold your own on the mic and get respect from a lot of the new school cats coming up?
Wow, that's a big question, man. You know what I mean? We got all the massive them, all the MCs and all the artists that perform in this scene here. But yeah, it's like maintaining, isn't it? You can get anything, but you got to maintain it. I think just updating with myself, updating. I've always updated my lyrics and moving with the times, and that's important as well. As well as I know, you know, I can come in the dance and chat lyrics what I wrote 10 years ago or that vibe there. But the new school as well, you got to keep your foot in that door as well and keep updating. You know what I mean? There's a lot of kids on the block, new kids on the block. And just to update and know that, yeah, man's legendary in there and still representing. But I do a bit of everything, do you know what I mean? And that's the way for me personally.
Wicked, is there any of the new guys that have come through that we should look out for?
Yeah, I mean, I've got my own little squad, you know what I mean? We got my high level massive them. There's loads of MCs that I could rule out loads of them. There's just so much artists out there that's coming through with DMB. DJs as well, there's a lot of new talent on the block. And the door's open for them as well. And, you know, it's the likes of these raves here, Jungle, do you know what I mean? That helped and paved that way. So I've got to respect even the olders for myself. There's a lot of olders, you know, older than me that was there for a long time. And respect to those guys as well, man, because without them, trust me, the youngers wouldn't be there now. There would be nothing there, do you know what I'm saying to you? So, boom, we got all the massive them, yeah.
Wiki, can you give us one of your best jungle memories?
Best jungle memories, there's been so many. You know, one thing I will say, and this is like my best memory, I mean, I've travelled the world and I am travelling all the time, and that's due to jungle music and DMB, do you know what I mean? Just becoming an MC in East London, you know, as a fun thing on the radio. I mean, I travel, this year I've been Australia, America, I was non-stop travelling all around the world. That's my memory, do you know what I'm saying? The whole of that is a big memory for me, you know what I'm saying? I'm travelling all the time as well, so give thanks and praise for that as well. But yeah, man, big up the jungle DMB for years without fears, trust me, long time.
Wicked, can you tell us a few of your favourite jungle tracks?
My few, definitely Pulp Fiction, 31 Seconds, Wolf, you know, them sort of tunes there, man, you know, Warhead. There's so many different eras, but that's my sort of era as well. Helicopter, Shy FX, a lot of Shy FX stuff back then as well was firing, you know what I'm saying? Still is, but in the jungle tunes, like you said, them days there, you would never get that sort of vibe from anywhere else, you know what I'm saying to you? Like even the music now, you can't see it lasting 20 years. You know, maybe it will do, you know what I'm saying? Who knows? But Jungle was built 20 years ago or 15 years ago, and them trees are still mashing up dances now. So credit to the producers as well, man, you know what I mean?
All right, so we're outside Jungle Mania. I got DJ Devious D. Now, Devious, obviously, you've been around for ages. I mean, I'm talking about you transcending, flipping the hardcore. You was like Prodigy DJ, stuff like that. We're here at Jungle Mania in 2013. What would you say the vibes are compared to how it was in the mid-90s when Jungle was in its heyday?
Well, the vibes are good, but not like when it first hit, like back in the day. But bear in mind, I've only been in the venue 5 minutes, but I heard it's been firing all night. But I can see that people are enjoying themselves. But when it was back in the day, it was fresh, as you can imagine. But here we are like 20 years later, and things are still going. That shows you how good the scene is.
Why do you think there's still such a demand for jungle music?
Because the music was good when it first came out. If something wasn't good, he still wouldn't be playing it 20 years later. That shows that the strength of the actual original jungle from back in the day right through to now.
Okay, so what kind of things do we expect to hear from you tonight in your set?
Tonight you're going to hear stuff from right back from 93, 94. With jungle, I'm going to be bringing jungle right up to 2013 and some specials along the way as normal.
Could you give me a few of your favourite jungle tracks?
28 Gun Bad Boy.
Done.
That's it.
Wicked. Also, can you give me a couple of your favourite jungle memories?
Jungle memories. Memories? I'd say Telepathy at the Michael Sobel Centre. I'm not sure what year that was, but that's the first time I've seen a full colour laser going across the top of 9,000 people in a 3,000 capacity venue.
What was it like touring with Prodigy?
Off the hook, unimaginable, you couldn't believe it. It's just like on the road, every single day, venue to venue, 30 different gigs we did over a month. It's off the hook.
Ladies, what makes jungle music so great?
The people that love jungle are just amazing, and just skanking out to jungle, you can really like properly let loose to it, and that's basically, yeah.
Yeah. What are your thoughts about the night?
Music amazing. MCs.
Too many MCs, not enough mics.
Too many MCs. More tunes. You need to hear more tunes.
The MCs are rather louder than the tunes, so it sort of blots out some of the music. Like, it'd have been nice to have one set with no MCs, just pure rolling drum and bass music. Definitely.
What about atmosphere? How do you, would you describe atmosphere?
It's been really good. Yeah,
it's been a really good,
wicked night.
Best night out in a long time.
Yes, definitely. Yes.
So what has been your favourite set so far?
Congo Nae. Yeah, definitely.
So what do you like about Jungle Mania?
It's having it,
and it's 20 years. It's 20 years, so it's all different eras of it, which is, instead of it being
it's got history.
Yeah.
Guys, do you have 5 favourite tracks of jungle music?
Remark R.O.P. definitely.
Congo Natty, Police and Helicopter.
Oh, and what's Weak As I Am? Code Red. Congo Natty, Code Red. Red. Yeah. For me, definitely. All the way. Yeah.
I don't know, I'm bigging up Remark every time.
If he just be like that.
Lovely. And do you have any jungle memories?
I don't know.
Lots of this.
Yeah.
Basically.
Lots of face.
Yeah, this is what all we like. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed your evening.
See you later.
Tomorrow.